Hey guys, thank you so much for stopping by the garden today. I just wanted to do a little video on my Echeveria Topsy Turvy because she's been growing really well. Now I had her outside when I first got her a couple months ago in about 8 to 10 hours of direct sun with my shade cloth. I have a little succulent cart out there that I bring in and out. I have all my highlight succulents on it and I control the rain it gets, the water it gets by being on that cart and I take it in and out. Well, this succulent on that cart was not doing so well. So I noticed it was starting to burn a little bit. So I took it in, I adjusted it into my eastern facing exposure inside and it's been growing really well. So I wanted to do a little update for you guys and just let you know some tips on how to grow this because when I first got it, I really didn't know how to take care of it. And although I have other succulents and other Echeveria succulents, you know, those Echeverias can take quite a bit of sunlight. This Echeveria Topsy Turvy really does not like a lot of sun all day long. So I put it in my eastern facing exposure and it gets only about 6 hours of direct sun a day. And you can see this nice little flower bloom starting to pop up. It's starting to turn yellow with some blooms in there and we're looking good. So she's about to bloom and I'm gonna do a little update for you guys and show you when she does bloom. But all I do is soak this pot all the way through the bottom, let it drain out and then let it dry in between the waterings. I use the soak and dry method for my succulents. So it just means soaking your pot all the way through till it runs out of the bottom, discarding any tray that's underneath after 5 or 10 minutes, and then you know you're good to go to wait. I always let my soil dry out for my succulents. Even in the summertime, I let my soil dry out for a good at least day to 4 days to a week between waterings. It all depends. You know, after a while, you'll start noticing a schedule for your succulents and how often they like water in the summertime, how often in the wintertime. Now, in the winter, a lot of my succulents go dormant, so I don't need to water too much. I only water maybe once every 3 weeks to a month. Right now, I'm watering this little Topsy Turvy about once a week because it's sucking up a lot of water. And I'm getting leaf death on the bottom, but that's totally normal. If you're getting leaf death and they're nice and crispy looking on the bottom, you're good to go. You know you're watering correctly. But if you're getting like mushy leaves or yellow leaves, it means that you might be watering just a little too much. So try to back off a little bit. Now we're not stretching, so we haven't been stretching out, which is really cool. I'm so happy that this succulent's not stretching. She's growing really compact and her bloom just looks absolutely gorgeous the way she's pushing up that bloom. And I just let this stay dry for a good, now she likes to be watered quite frequently. She sucks up a lot of energy, especially when they're flowering and in their growing season. In the summer she grows, so they're gonna use up a lot of energy right now. And I always soak my pots all the way through to the bottom when these bottom leaves feel deflated. So once they feel a little deflated to the touch, you wanna just go ahead and squeeze the bottom leaves. Just try not to touch the top because this does have a powdery coating on it and you'll tend to take that coating off and it's just a sun protector for it. It just looks kinda ugly when you go ahead and put fingerprints all over it. So try to touch the bottom when you are handling it and you are pushing on the leaves. You want to make sure they're deflated and a little bit wrinkly looking before you go ahead and water again. And that's going to plump it right back up. It's going to stay wet, moist in there after you water for a good couple of days. But after about 4 days, 5 days, your pots should be completely dry. They should be on their way to almost dry because if not, you know, succulents don't like wet roots for a long time. So that's why I give them that break between the waterings. It just lets them recoup, lets their roots dry out, and it just lets them, you know, grow and be healthier. They will lose the bottom leaves as they grow, so they have a lot of water storage and they're very drought tolerant, especially at this stage when they're this big. So thank you so much for watching, you guys. I just feed with a all-purpose nutrients. It's from Dynagrow. I use Dynagrow Grow System and it's a 795 water soluble nutrient system. And I water with nutrients at the beginning of the growing season. So when I first got this 2 months ago in May, 3 months ago actually, I went ahead and treated with some nutrients, and then I'm not treating anymore until next season. So only one time a year I treat with that 795 and I cut it in half sometimes. Sometimes I give a full feeding, sometimes I give half of a feeding. It all depends, but they can tolerate the full feeding of the 795. Thank you so much for watching, you guys. If you have any questions on this Topsy Turvy, just let me know. I'm always here for you and I'd love to help you in any way possible. Thank you so much for stopping by, you guys, and I'll see you next time out in the garden. Bye-bye.